we on our way to Barcelona. We on our way to Barcelona. I'm so glad I got that on camera, finally.
Oh, finally. Wow.
Be my man, it's taking myself to the door in Barcelona. We're on our way to Barcelona. Okay, y'all, we got to the airport. The airport was super damn packed. And then we found out this guy needs to go get his booster. So we head into HEB to go get the booster. And then we will catch a later flight. Thank God that our connecting flight leaves so late, because we didn't have to pay anything to change flights, and we will still make it for our Barcelona flight. Say God is good. Say God is good.
Leave me alone.
All right, so we on our way back to the airport. We got our vaccination cards, and Rodney and I have had two arguments, both about driving. So the lesson learned here is to let his ass drive, because can't nobody drive better than him since he got his CDL, even though he the one. Never mind, I ain't been going to all his business. But he captain know how to drive everywhere. With a yo butt knee behind the steering wheel, and I shouldn't touch another steering wheel. Nowhere we go. Alright, we're on our way back to the airport. Rodney
is ghetto as heck. Ghetto ass guy out of Detroit, Michigan.
Oh, your dark skinned ass thing. You just made it.
Your big neck ass. I know you ain't talking shit.
Look at your neck. It don't even come out of the hoodie.
That's why your braids crooked.
And that's why your beard got a blue spot.
What? Oh, okay. All right.
Anyway, we on our way to Spain. The devil ain't stop us. You got the vaccination, get an exam, and the passport.
Can y'all believe Tib made us come through to the airport without having all the stuff we needed? Tell the truth.
In my defense, they didn't send me anything saying that we needed anything, so I didn't know.
I tell you what, if I would have missed my trip, you were going to give it to me and ask the cash.
Well, God is good. We ain't missed nothing.
I'm still getting one of them.
Yes, it's ass, because the cash is spent. Okay. Let's go back to the check-in.
We back, please. Thought we weren't going to make it?
You thought? Okay, we are finally in the TSA line. My eyes are puffy and my nose is red.
She was crying.
Because American Airlines is some of the most, what is the word? Unorganized, undertrained people I have experienced. Like, they sent us away to get our vaccination cards because they said our COVID test was not enough. When they sent me the information, they said, specifically. I even came up to the terminal and got it, and they verified got to the desk, and it is and COVID test and the vaccination card. So like I was saying, we almost had our flight canceled or whatever, because they don't even know who to let through, on what circumstance to let who through. And yeah, the tears started coming. They didn't ruin my Philadelphia surprise for my honey, and for nothing. Like, I literally could have went through it this morning.
The surprise was her giving me booty, y'all.
I'm so sorry.
Oh, no, you good. Yeah.
What she do?
She was in the video.
Oh, I don't care.
Yeah, we don't.
I'm care. Like, why am I in that? Why am I in my phone?
Yeah, but anyway, we are headed through TSA now. So, hopefully the rest of this trip go off without a scape. It's some good weather, some good food, and some good entertainment.
You think they have Wi-Fi on the international thing?
Yeah.
You think I'd be able to watch the game? Probably not, because YouTube TV ain't going to change over there. They're going to be like, nigga, what are you?
Who do you think you are?
Yeah, what are you right now? Because if you try to get us, we don't even know what area to ping you off of.
Okay, we made it to Philly. Say yay. Oh, you lame. Say yay. Thank you. Thank you very much. All right, so yeah, we made it to Philly. I was asleep the entire flight, so I'm not even going to cap. It was a 4-hour flight, so I think that was some great sleep, honestly. Karate's a cranky old man, as always, but let's see what adventures American has for us in this next chapter. Cool crew. All
right, y'all. So we in Philly, and as always, it's me versus everybody out here, even her, man, even her. So look, this morning started out terrible, but we're making up for it because, huh? Okay, yeah. We're making up for it because we are finally in Philly and the next connection flight is to Barcelona. Outside of that, we are having a good time. As long as we are together, as y'all can see, Tia got her stunner shake. Tia got her shades on. She thinks she's feeling herself.
I got my cornrows.
She done had like two people tell us they love her stuff. And so, hey, but we'll check in with y'all in the next stop. Peace.
Okay, so boom, we are finally about to load the Barcelona flight. It takes 7 hours, and there is a 7-hour time difference, right? So we will be getting there at 2 a.m. our time, 9 a.m. their time. So I think this will be our first experience with jet lag. How do you feel to be going to Barcelona?
It's a feeling of euphoria.
Euphoria, ooh. Shout out to Zendaya.
Shout out to Zendaya, yeah. Well, what the little kid name that was?
Ashtray.
I'm more like Ashtray. Nah, I really am excited, man. It's, I don't know, I'm overwhelmed with emotion. I can't believe she did this for me. Get y'all a teal.
Only one, and you got her.
And I'm clapping. All right. All right, we on the way to Barcelona. Shake that ass, no, shake that ass, shake that ass. Yeah, I'm ready to go.
Okay, so we're finally in Barcelona. And we're on like this subway car. It's like giving me mad New York vibes. So, it's 2 a.m. our time, but 9 a.m. 3 a.m. our time, but 9 a.m. their time. And I think I'm experiencing jet lag, so.
I'm exhausted, like, ready to get to sleep for sure.
Yes. All right, we'll check in later. We got a Barcelona stamp. Barcelona stamp. Y'all know Rodney is not a morning person, and he's tired and hungry, but we got a Barcelona stamp. We got a Barcelona stamp. Oh, good morning. We are literally exhausted. It just took like an hour to find out.
Please give me your coat.
Oh, he said can't record.
Huh? We did. Put in next fare. Got a bar.
Yeah. Huh? Oh, they got us on the corner?
Everything's wood here.
Hey, give me the key. Yeah, check out the keys right there, bro. They got bamboo keys here.
I'm taking it home for a souvenir.
Taking it home. Alright. Let's see what we got.
Hello.
Not them, the one
that was
in.
Try again.
Hi. Drink.
Por dentro.
I gotta do it.
Por dentro.
Okay. Oh, man.
It's push.
I'm high. Wow.
Okay.
That's
Leo.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. Oh, wow. This is nice.
Got a steam.
Uh-oh.
I'm trying to see what this bathroom hitting on.
See, you know I'm going to get you in the class, right?
Yeah. Annihilation.
Everybody about to see you.
Oh, my God.
Everybody about to see you.
This is so nice.
Nice. It opened all the way around.
Oh, my goodness. I'm trying to see what the bathroom looks like.
Oh, this is crazy.
Is it two showers?
You gotta
toilet. Oh, toilet. Okay.
Okay. I'm digging it. This is nice.
You sound so delicate.
Oh, the door right there. I see hinges. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. We got our. Oh, yeah. Right here on the bathroom. Right here on the bathroom in front of everybody. Oh, yes, sir.
They going to be like, Miss Prescott. No, actually. Oh, this is all our balcony.
Oh, yeah.
We got the biggest balcony. I did good.
I'm going to
get
on the balcony.
And we at the top. Hold on. We at the top.
Yeah. Yeah. We're going to be like,
We pay for that. We pay for it too. With the small balcony ass. Oh. I'm so glad it's nice. Put us in there on the menu.
Menu?
Yes.
What menu? Yeah, right there.
Oh.
Nice. You gotta get the title when we go out.
Uh-huh. Give me. Never mind, got me.
Oh, yeah, you got you.
That look cute.
Yeah, you do.
Okay.
Nice jacket.
Because they know what they want. We ain't know that.
I got jackets, man. I got long sleeves too. We just got up and ain't drinking.
I might have to go to H&M and get me a jacket.
I can't wait to wear H&M tomorrow.
That H&M look nice through that window.
Hey, I am anxious to go to H&M. No cap. Okay, we got the green right there.
We ain't got no, it's
right
red.
Here.
Oh.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
you
got it.
You got it.
Okay.
Okay.
No, we don't, actually.
It is so cool that like people walk here. You actually have to follow the street lights so your ass will get red and fuck
up. Man, because these roads kind of difficult.
My pizza, Miss Sexy.
Oh, yeah.
I guess we can take off
right here. Look, I don't care. We can take off on every road by yourself here.
By myself?
Yes. So right now it's like 4:30 in the morning, but it feels like maybe 10 a.m. to us because of the time difference. So we're wide awake looking retarded. But later on today is Rodney, my love's birthday. He'll be 28 and we're going to do some sightseeing of Spain. I scheduled a tour for us for the Sagrada Familia, which is a either 100-year-old or 200-year-old cathedral that has a lot of Barcelona history in it. So I'm excited about that. And we're going to the Parc Güell, which is about a 30-minute walk from there. And so hopefully we'll see some cool stuff to get into while we explore inside of Barcelona. Right now we are in the Gothic Quarter, which is like the historical center of where they started building out Barcelona. Honestly, we were a bit nervous coming. Well, I was a bit nervous coming to Barcelona because everyone claimed that, you know, Barcelona is not nice to black people. But we've went to 2 restaurants so far. We've been here for an entire day so far, and everyone has had nothing but big old smiles towards us and pure kindness. A lot of the residents have been guiding us around about where to go, try new stuff and whatnot. I had about a 2-hour conversation with a white couple here from Spain on the airplane about just, I don't know, my life, I guess. And then he sat next to a nice lady who lives here 6 months out of the year and goes back home to America 6 months out of the year, and she's been sending us an itinerary of things to view in Barcelona. So I guess the learning lesson in that is don't listen to what everybody has to say about a country. If you want to visit a country, all you can do is go ahead and visit it. If you have a bad experience, I mean, I'm sure you won't be there for more than a week, and if you are, just pay for a ticket to go back home. This world is too big to not explore and see different people, different cultures. You know, life is too short, and I really don't believe we're gonna look back and say, I should have bought a bigger TV or that type of car. We're gonna feel bad about the places we didn't get to see in our life. What I love about Barcelona is, and I'll try to get a more of a close-up on some of the buildings and the architecture, but it seems like they put detail into every building. Like, these buildings are not modern. Like, even the new buildings, like our hotel was built a year ago, but it doesn't look modern. Like, it looks earthy and on par of like the culture that is here in Barcelona. And the real old buildings, man, we saw one building that had little baby angels etched on every single window. Like, that is detail. That is attention. That is time. Like, these people, and what I haven't seen a lot of is there are not a lot of tourists here. Like, everyone that we've seen here lives here. Now, I don't know if that is COVID or if that's just Barcelona, Spain, but these people have so much pride in their living. I love it. I'm excited to see what day 2 brings to us. Hopefully I can get a couple more Z's before
the Celebrate Stout, so that we have energy to really explore and have a good time. Also, it seems like their H&M is completely different from ours. Like, they had some really detailed and luxurious outfits. So, I'm excited to go check out there and hopefully do some shopping.
All right, y'all. Enough of all that. Let me take y'all outside. Look at Barcelona, y'all. Like, I'm gonna just fail. But look at Barcelona. Can y'all believe we out here in Spain? Like, we really in Spain right now, y'all. Like, look at my fucking view. It is dead right now. But hey, thank you guys for everyone that's gonna tell me happy birthday. I'm so blessed, so thankful, and enjoy everything. And thank you to my baby Tia, because hey, she got me all the way out for my birthday. Best future wife ever.
What's up, y'all? It's Barcelona. I knew since I watched Cheetah Girls that I wanted to go to Barcelona in my adult years. And I just thank God that I was able to do that. It's absolutely beautiful today. Here's the weather. It's a little bit more chilly than Texas, but it's still beautiful. And today we're going to do a couple of tours, and then we're going to go to the pharmacy to get our COVID test so that we can get back into the United States. But yeah, I'm just enjoying the moment, the sightseeing. It's quiet and morning. American time is like 2 a.m. in the morning, but here it's like 10, so we don't want to waste the sunlight. Things do close up pretty early here, so we want to get out and have a little fun and see what we get into. So we'll be checking in every so often. I also want to see if I can do some cool stuff, because today is Rodney's birthday, and you know, want to turn up and party for the birthday boy. Oh, so one thing about here, it's not big on like actual like partying. It's really just people living. Like, no one's really like dressing up, dressing to impress. It's just people living there every day, which I love. It's so carefree. I talked to somebody, living here is super inexpensive, and yeah, it just really makes you look side eye at American standards, because I mean, shoot, we pay almost $2,000 in rent. They pay like $600 here. Okay, I'll get some cool stuff for y'all to see today.
Texas. Okay. We don't have any of this in America. Wanna make our friends out?
Natural groceries, yeah, Sprouts. Oh, they got lotion, because you know I need some lotion.
Yeah, it's like a...
with the heart, right there. Uh-huh. They said, played at Jesus Christmas. Mm-hmm. They had go up to the left of the ladies of that heart. That's supposed to be Mary, kind of baby Jesus.
Right there?
And the two beside it will be Mary and Joseph. And then at the top, you can see that's supposed to be when Jesus was like a teenager, basically. And they say it's front part, it's going to be the beginning of his life. Mm-hmm. If you look to the left right here, that's Joseph. He's supposed to be playing with baby Jesus. And then if you look up there, the three wise men playing.
Okay, y'all, so we just left the tattoo shop and we're gonna get a tattoo tomorrow.
Yes.
Matching tattoos on a ring finger for the engagement, and for then the I mean for the wedding.
You don't get matching tattoos for the engagement.
For the wedding, and then Rodney's getting a neck tattoo of a wolf.
Yeah.
So he's super excited. Right now, we're heading to our first tour of Spain, which is gonna be the Sagrada Familia. It's an hour and a half tour. I don't know if they'll let us bring our phone in there, but if they do, you know I'm gonna get some good stuff. Yeah, anything you wanna say?
No.
Okay. Bye y'all for now.
Confused by that story because they say Gabriel knew how to fight, but Michael was an archangel. But both of them are angels, but Michael was a fighter. Gabriel was a messenger angel. I'm always confused by the story. So the lady with the heart right there. Uh-huh. They said played at Jesus Christmas. myself to be like thankful for my sister and
okay, so right now we're inside of the Sagrada Familia, which is a Catholic church here in Barcelona. How do you feel being in here?
That's cool, man. It felt like it's a, I don't know, the story behind the church is so cool, man. Like the history of it, they're not even done being built. Like it's been the 1920.
That's when he died, but 40 years prior.
Yeah, so it's been generation after generation that they've been building this church, and they only done three phases so far. But no, two. They've only done completed two phases, and then they got to complete the third one. And it's symbolic because one phase represents the beginning, the other phase represents death, and the other phase represents resurrection. So the story behind it is good. You know, it's not hearing the story and what the plan was and then coming inside of it is, man, you gotta see it. Why am I on my papers? you gotta come in here and see it. That's it. Okay.
My big old mouth, but we just left the Sagrada Familia. I had a come to Jesus moment, for lack of better words. Like inside of the building, we were only able to see three out of four phases, but it just showed like a common goal in religion. And I feel that coming from the States, people really have gotten or are starting to get away from the sense of religion. And you don't see that here in Barcelona. Like, those people love God. They respect God. And I think that in itself is so beautiful and really hones in on why they're so peaceful here. They never lost sight, or they're not losing sight of, like, their love for God, Jesus Christ, and even the apostles. I'll tag in some videos I took of the building, but you can really see the heart and love that went into every detail of the building. So, great experience. Right now we're at this place called Enrique Thomas, and we're trying steak, we're trying seafood, and yeah, just trying everything. You want to say anything?
I didn't want to say anything.
Ronnie don't want to talk to y'all in this moment. He wants to eat and see what else we can get into before the night comes. All right, y'all. Bye. Okay, y'all. It's time for my day two synopsis. We are at, again, Occidental Diagonal 414 here in Barcelona. Yesterday for me was an absolutely amazing time. The way that these people treat their people is just so beautiful. Like, for example, me and Rodney, we went and got massages yesterday, and because we were last minute, they had to do mine or his at 5 and mine at 7. So I had to wait. So Rodney went back to the hotel to take a nap, and I stayed at the nail shop waiting till 7 to go ahead and get my pedicure. Well, the lady saw me waiting, and she said, well, since you're going to be here waiting, do you want to go out and walk around and then come back for your pedicure? I was like, do you want me to pay right now? She said, no, just go ahead, just come back. Of course, I went back and got my massage, and it put me to sleep, like, embarrassing snoring sleep. But just the trust that she had for a complete stranger
to leave with her hard-earned money and trust them to come back and get their service. On top of that, like, to get the appointment, she didn't even ask me to put nothing down for the appointment. She just asked for my name and said, come back at 5 and come back at 7. And then she let me leave before even paying for the 5 o'clock service. And she trusted me to come back. So that just meant a lot, because I don't think any business had ever trusted me, not just because of who I am, but they never trusted me to leave with their money and come back and get the secondary service, or even just hold up their time to book the appointment in the first place. So it just speaks to like how these people trust their people. What else? Oh, so when I actually left, I went and got a glass of wine from a local bar around the corner. Y'all, I was expecting to pay like maybe $9, $10, $11, $12 for this glass of wine. It was $2.75 and a delicious glass of red wine. And then dinner, we've been eating dinner for like maybe $30 in total. Pretty much every meal we've eaten here as a couple has been $30, but we always get drinks and like one or two drinks a piece, and then we eat an appetizer and a meal, and it comes out to about $30-$35. A couple of our meals have been only $26. So although the euro is stronger than the American dollar, their cost of living seems to be a lot less. We looked into the price of apartments, and an apartment is anywhere between $800 to $1,200 in the Gothic Quarter, which is considered their downtown, the most historic part of Barcelona. But if you go out into the city, you can get a two-bedroom, two-bath for like $650. I don't know. I think, you know, maybe America is doing something wrong, because these people are living great. They're happy. They're peaceful. And, you know, we were told that Barcelona don't like black people. I think they love them, because we have been treated with nothing but kindness every day that we've been here, like smiles and help and greetings. And everyone doesn't speak English. Like, they speak Catalan, Portuguese, some Spanish, some French, but niceness, just, it translates across all languages. And so, like, they've just been 100% nice, 100% homey. And I'm really enjoying my time. We got 2 days left here, so I'll try to get some cool video. I think today we're going to the aquarium, so I'll be back, y'all. Okay, y'all, so we are in a tattoo shop here in Spain. Rodney's about to get a wolf on his neck, so I'll be taking a video of that. Rodney, are you excited?
Yes.
Yes. And then we're gonna get some wedding tattoos. We'll be back.
It's different.
I mean, I got this one, but this ain't the same.
No, because you feel
the bone.
Yeah. It's a little bit, but I go dot by dot. Mm-hmm. I think it's better, okay? Mm-hmm. I try a little bit and you tell me.
He's gonna hit you with that, más o menos. Más o menos.
It's different.
Yeah, it's whatever.
It's a movie.
It's a, yeah.
Well, your eyes just twitch.
Yeah.
zoom in. You want to make it your face in it. Cause look at this dot from Detroit getting tattooed. I done, she getting married. Now she getting my ring on her finger.
Okay, y'all. We just got our tattoos. I took mine like a gangster, cause I am. He took his all right.
I got a whole thing on the side.
Show him. And then this one. Let him eat his donut. It's delicious, ain't it? Show him your ring.
If you like it, then you should have put a ring on it.
Okay, y'all, it's the final night here in Spain. We are about to go get our COVID test so that we can get back to the U.S. with no hitches or issues. And then hopefully we make it to the aquarium today. We got so caught up doing like the things that we showed you that we weren't able to get to the aquarium. But I haven't been to an aquarium in the States before, so I think it'll be 100% special if I'm able to get to an aquarium here in Barcelona, Spain. My tattoo looks great today. Rodney's looks great as well. And yeah, let's see what we can get into on this Sunday. So here in Spain, Sunday is kind of like their Sabbath day. So a lot of things aren't open. There's not a lot of people on the street like there was yesterday or the rest of the week. And last night we learned the hard way that they don't really do dinner here. They do wine, coffee, cheese, and cakes at dinner time. So I ended up ordering some Chinese food from the local Chinese spot, and it was not like American Chinese food, but it wasn't that bad. It wasn't that bad. Of course, there's my honey, Rodney G, soon to be Mrs. G. So yeah, let's go ahead and walk and get to this COVID test before we run out of time. Bye. Do you want to say anything?
No.
Okay. Bye, y'all.
Walking through the alleys of Barcelona.
It's to the right. Apartments. Looking like a real Spanish man over here. Do a little. Hey, hit this shit. Ah! Okay, so we're here getting our COVID test. Fast. Y'all, we just got beat up by a nurse. Oh my god. She stuck that Q-tip so far up my nose.
I ain't never had a COVID test that deep.
Oh my god.
Bro, she was up there touching my brain trying to figure out what's going on.
I started crying and coughing. Oh my goodness.
I asked her, well, did the test come back in my dome or no? Because that's how far she was up there. My brain getting touched.
Lord Jesus. Okay, so we're still pretty tired, so we're going to go find something to eat, hopefully, because it is their Sabbath, and then go to the hotel and chill. We might come back out later at night, we might not, but Barcelona owes us absolutely nothing.
Nothing.
At least, yeah, see, nothing.
Nothing.
We had a blast. These people are so nice, yes, and peaceful and loving, yes, and helpful. I'm going to miss it, but this won't be our last time in Barcelona.
Oh yeah, definitely won't be the last time in Barcelona. I might move out here.
I mean, everything is pretty cheap. Rent is cheap, food is cheap, water's cheap, hotels are cheap.
People are good.
People are good and nice. No undertones of racism. Okay, y'all. See y'all later.
Bye.
Okay, y'all. We leaving out.
We leaving out.
It's the last day Yeah, I got you on camera doing that. It's the last day of Barcelona.
Barcelona.
Stop, motherfucker, damn.
You got makeup all on your new jacket.
Yeah, okay, I washed off. Rodney.
Nah, you saw me earlier this morning. Let's tell the truth. Tell the truth.
Rodney.
Tell the truth. Tell the truth.
I hope you get canceled. Anyway.
I don't give a fuck.
Rodney!
Okay, okay, I'm going to start off the video. I'm going to go do it right. Start the video over.
Move. Oh, God. Anyway, it's the last day before we head back to the States. Barcelona personally owes me nothing. What was your favorite part of the trip, babe?
The people. The people here are really, really nice. I don't want to go back. And the cheap prices on everything.
Facts.
Cheap prices on everything.
The favorite part for me was seeing the Sagrada Familia. Honestly, the shower inside of the hotel, I feel like I might have to go ahead and figure out where the heck to get that from. Definitely the people. So nice. I felt no undertones of racism. You know what I mean, Americans. And yeah, it was just a carefree living. Like, just drink wine, talk to your significant other. Everyone booed up. I can definitely understand why they call it the country of love. It's so romantic here. It's like a known thing that you get here, you grow up, you get your partner, and y'all live and love each other. Any takeaway from this country? AOD. Any takeaway from this country?
I'm a badass kid over here, like in the back. Takeaway. Definitely. Don't move too. Stop. Definitely don't move too fast with your life, man. Like, I think that's their motto over here. Like, not overworking, not overeating, not overdoing anything. I think the one thing they do the most over here is drink wine and mingle. They don't move too fast. And it should be a life lesson translating into our work home life back home. Like, nobody here works themselves to the ground. You see old people literally in their 70s and 80s, like with their wives and husbands, like walking up and down the street for miles just to have fun and engage with the people and drink wine. I don't think they want to live too harsh out here. America's society has told them to work ourselves to the ground, just barely live a reasonable life. I don't think that translates to any other country. So yeah, I'm definitely taking that back with me. That whole mentality back with me, like just not overworking myself.
Great information. For me, it was the grocery stores on every corner. I feel like the fact that you have to drive 5, 6, 7 miles to get fresh produce is crazy with America, when we witness here on every single block. They had grocery stores, supermarkets, 24-hour stores with fresh produce. And meat. Now, meat, I'm probably gonna take a lot of that out of my diet, because what I realized is in a week I probably ate meat like twice, and the meat that I ate, because it wasn't American meat, tasted totally different, and I was like, oh, I don't want that anyway. So I ate a lot of vegan vegetarian meals, which was cool because I don't do that in the States. So I might try to incorporate more vegetarian meals into my diet, or not my, I will. Also eating more salad and drinking more wine, because for some reason that seems to keep them full and happy. And I will admit, over these last 3-4 days, I ain't do nothing but giggle and snort more than I have in a while. And sleep, baby. I think I got a collective of 27 hours of sleep.
I think we definitely like living wrong, like, and that's why like American meat is outlawed. Like, we can't find our meat. We literally found chicken wings.
And they still wasn't even chicken wings.
So it's like the shit that they giving us over there and making us participate in gluttony, man, they don't do that over there.
They don't even have a lot of snacks.
They don't even have a lot of snacks. Like snacks, meat, nothing. They cheese, salami,
bread,
and bread and wine. That's it. They don't eat heavy dinners. It's always
big lunches.
And
not even big. They were like a regular meal size lunch. And then
snack for dinner. They wine for dinner. Mm-hmm.
That's a great lifestyle to have. Like, all the people here skinny from top to bottom. Not even like that skinny, like they work out skinny, but like it's like if their bodies are made to be that way. So we're going to try to do the wine, cheese, and coffee diet of Spain for 30, 60 days, and we'll let you know how that goes. My last question is, would you live here?
Yes. I would live in Spain if it meant, I wouldn't want to live here like, I would do dual visa. Like, I would be here half the year, and I mean, anytime you know me. I do here half here a year, half here in the States or something like that. But would I, if I had to live here full time, would I? Yes. Because I feel like low key, they emphasis on the word live. Like, they live. They don't just survive. I think that's what we're doing in the States, is surviving. So
I agree. I will live here because it's inexpensive, even though the currency is stronger than the U.S. Shade, I don't care. But things were costing, like, a glass of wine in the States probably cost $9 to $13. Here, $2.70 to $3.70.
And they pour it.
Everywhere.
And they pour it.
And drunk.
Drunk, yeah.
And not that we was even supposed to. That's another, like, showing that we're American. Like, no one was drunk. Yeah. And me and Rodney was having a good time. Okay. So, it was so many takeaways from this trip. But overall, Barcelona just may see us very soon. We'll be back with another travel vlog in a couple months because we're getting married in July and we got our honeymoon in August. So we'll be back traveling the world as a black couple.